going to last long in all this radiation?
Thank you. Come on, leave it.
Bingo.
Time to go already?
what? Since we talked, I'm feeling swell. Look at the two of us here in Sanctuary. Prepared for the future.
I need to ask you something.
Another settlement has sent word that they need our help. I'll mark it on your map. We can use all the support we can get. So, see what you can do to help.
I took care of those super mutants. The settlers were relieved to not have them to worry about anymore.
Thank God. Super mutants. Civilians just don't stand a chance against them. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Ben send you?
Yes, I'm here to help.
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies, threatening us if we can't give them. We know where they're coming.
Right. Don't worry. I'll take...
I hope so.
Uh-huh.
Yes?
Another bit of news from the world outside Diamond City. Folks, I'm going to tell you a little story about a boy named Billy. Now, Billy lives here in the Commonwealth. He wasn't spared the harsh realities of that life any more than the rest of us. He found himself separated from his family. Then, he managed to run into the Vault Dweller. I'm happy to report that with the Vault Dweller's help, he was reunited. Keep it tuned here, folks.
Well,
to Diamond City Radio.
Stuff anymore.
Dead set on making it shake.
Nothing.
Only a fucking coward hides.
No sign of him now.
And that was Roy Brown. Now, folks, I'm sure you've all seen or heard about the latest issue of Public Occurrences. Some bold claims by our intrepid reporter. Since possibly living among us, undetected. Very serious implications. Wouldn't you agree? The mayor's office has, of course, issued a statement denying the validity of the article, saying all is well in Diamond City. The mayor himself insists that the fears raised in the article are unfounded. Good to know, I guess. But between you and me, listeners, I'm gonna keep my eyes open just to be on the safe side. Well, never a dull moment here at Diamond City Radio. Next, we'll hear Civilization by Danny Kaye. Number. Good news is something often in short supply in the Commonwealth, folks. So I'm happy to be able to deliver a little bit to you. If you were one of the folks worrying in hushed tones about the whereabouts of Diamond City's most effective detective, you can rest easy. Nick Valentine is back in town and seemingly none the worse for wear. While details about what happened to him are scarce, I for one am just glad he's back. And in one piece. And if there's any more good news to share, you'll hear it first here on Diamond City Radio. Up next, Frankie Carl and Marjorie Hughes share their hope for one more tomorrow. Louis Jordan, folks. Gotta love him. Folks, I think by now we're all used to a little weirdness every once in a while. This tidbit really takes the cake. And you gotta believe me when I say, I'm not making this up. There have been reports of, I'm dead serious now, a Chinese submarine seen off the coast, heading out to sea. How long it's been here, and what it's been up to, are anyone's guess, but I think we should all be thankful. It's apparently on its way out. Like I said, hard to believe. But there you have it, folks, the latest, craziest news from Diamond City Radio. There's no getting away from Ray Smith. Here's right behind you, baby. That was Bing Crosby, folks. Travis Lonely Miles here with the latest news update from the Commonwealth. And this one sounds heavy. The Green Tech Building, long known as a haven for gutter mercenaries, was recently assaulted by an unknown group. From what I understand, there aren't any gunners left to tell the tale. If that's true, it's a little unsettling. Those guys meant business. There are rumors circulating that the Institute was somehow involved. Now, I know, they come up every time something bad or unexplained happens. But in this case, even I have to admit, it's hard to not suspect they were involved. Don't jump to conclusions, but keep your wits about you, folks. And don't worry. At this time, there's no reason to suspect our fair city is in danger. So you just sit back and enjoy some quality music. Courtesy of Diamond City Radio. Truly one of the greatest voices ever. Here's Nat King Cole with Orange Colored Sky. That was Roy Brown with Butcher Pete. Non-stop music and all the latest news. This is Diamond City Radio. This is Travis Lonely Miles bringing you Johnny Mercer's personality. Something I only recently acquired, as I'm